your Caribou Data Science Channel YouTube. Tonight we're going to try to do the impossible. We're going to try to import 12 files containing 3.48 million rows into an Excel spreadsheet. How's that for a grabber? Huh? As always, you're going to start with the all this. Okay, let's just call it bike share right now. Okay. Now, the key is the data tab. We're going to import a from a folder. Okay. So we're going to import all 12 CSV files in here. And we're going to say load. Oh, we didn't do that right, did we? Oh, man, Dave. Let's cancel that. Let's go back. Okay, so let's try again. Data and sort query file folder data. Transform data. You get rid of all these columns here. Move columns to this. So now here we are. We're ready to transform the data. We're going to say OK. Let's do a transform. Let's do a quick row count again. It should be 3.48 million. Yep, 3.48 million. Very good. View, transform. Oh. Okay. So let's get. Remove that column there. Okay, now come over here. First thing we want to do is come over here, remove rows, blank rows. And remove rows, blank rows, errors. We're going to change type. Because unless I'm mistaken, some of these stationing actually have letters in them. So look over here also. Do this. Remove rows. Blank rows.
Even strength underscore goal. Equal. Goals minus. Outside underscore goals.
Yes. Right back. One moment. What?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm back. Okie dokie. So let's come back over here then. I'll do this. Come over here. Remove blank rows. Remove errors. Let's come over here. Let's change type. Text. Change type. Okay. Just come over here. Let's see, so do a transform date. Date only. Now this probably isn't the best way to do that. We'll see what happens. Wait, what is this doing here? Date, date only. Let's come back over here again then. Let's do start date. Okay. Time. Start hour. Okay, so let's come back over here now. Into that. Duplicate row. Okay, we're actually getting pretty doggone close. I mean, the only thing we really have to calculate after this is just going to be okay. Let's move this back over here. Okay. Now, last thing we want to do is calculate duration. Do this and do this. Age, date. I wonder why this doesn't work. Let's try this again. Let's see. Duration. Oh, man. Can we undo this somehow? Okay. Now, for whatever reason is. Okay, shoot. Duplicate column, transform to hours. So where was it? Where would it have been then? Days out. There. So we're trying to time only. Let's see here. So we're very close right now. The only thing we really need to figure out again is how to that's the wrong one. Okay, time. Subtract. Okay. Okay. How can we do this? cycle listed. Very good. Okay, now we're going to get to the tricky part here. So, we should be doing a connection only. Add this. Hey. As you can see, it is still $270,000 errors. How can that be? Maybe not, I don't know. There certainly could have been 270,000 errors. Well, I mean, do we really have 270,000 errors? Over here, cyclist at bike share. Oh, I don't know. What's the? I don't know what to call them. Bikes, right? So now if we come down here and we say where well, there is 122,000 rows there. Good. Well, this is really strange. How can you have 396,000 errors and still have all the data being imported? Now, the difference is apparently, okay, the difference is we're not actually importing the data. It's just like a connection. Honestly, I'm not quite sure what it really is, okay? Does this actually connect from here through Power Query to the CSV files, or does Power Query find some way to import all this data into Power Query? But the good news is we pretty much accomplished everything. But as you can see, what we can check is the is the data view, or is the data table view.
This Alan Deeper is of a freak. He's currently sitting in my lap. Try not to be offended by it. How's your ego? Looking much better. We scratch the inside of our ear.
So how long has recording been going on? 23 minutes. So I'm missing something as far as. So is this really loading data, or is it just loading the connection? Let's go over here. Go to YouTube. Search for XL connection. I'm not sure if this is quite right, but let's just do this. Home, insert, data table. Okay, actually, apparently my, let me see, sir. Testing, 1, 2, 3, testing, 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 testing. Okay. Oh, you know what it could be? My headphones could be dead. Maybe. Okay, let's just come back over here. Sure not missing. So we could say, for instance, start date. Let's do this. So I come over here now. Group. Now we got so this is the rows per date. So this should be, simply put, our so these would be roughly the rides per day based on the start date. Okay? Point. Let's see, data, manage data model. So now we have our data model. Data view, show hidden, so calculation area, find, pivot table, refresh. So this is a beautiful thing we got here. Let's add a trend line. Logarithmic scale, polynomial scale, exponential, mean average. We don't want a dash. So, fourteen period moving average. Okay. So, what you just witnessed right here was the first steps towards Dawn, the cyclistic bike share data analysis in Excel using Power Query and data models. So this concludes the YouTube version of this stream tonight. I will continue doing it on live stream. Okay. Well, I'm going to continue to do this on Okay. So I'm going to conclude this this recording for this evening. That's about a 32-minute call. You could probably hang in here and watch this whole video. Hope you find this video helpful and useful, and hopefully it gives you enough knowledge to actually go back. But here's the point. You're still better off using something other than Excel to do the initial data cleaning and wrangling. The only thing you want to use Excel for, if you possibly can, is data visualization and dashboards. Okay? Nonetheless, in using Power Query, we were able to fix the dates, we were able to calculate trip duration, and we were able to pull out just the hour that the ride took place. So pretty much, and we also did a lot of data cleaning. Matter of fact, we apparently moved over 273,000 rows, okay? So anyway, thanks so much for your time this evening, YouTube. Hope you find our support helpful. Comments are always welcome in the bottom below.